Hello and welcome. If you're a marketer or a small business owner with a website, chances are that you're using Google tags like Google Analytics 4 or Google Ads to measure the performance of your marketing. But with today's tougher privacy rules and ad blockers, those tags might not be capturing all the data you need, or they could be slowing down your site. Today's tutorial was actually inspired by a presentation I attended at MeasureCamp Bratislava, led by Karolina from Google, where she explained that Google Tag Gateway helps the Google tags behave like they're part of your website, not random third-party intruders. And I knew I had to test it, and now I'm bringing this setup to you in this tutorial. First things first, what exactly is Google Tag Gateway for advertisers? You can think of it as a bridge that lets Google tracking scripts cross over from Google servers to your own domain. In a standard setup, your Google Analytics or Google Ads tags load from Google's URL, and this can slow down your site, and sometimes those external requests get blocked by browsers or ad blockers, leading to gap in your data. Google Tag Gateway changes that by loading the tag from your site's URL and sending the data to Google through your site as well. This approach has some benefits. By keeping the tags first party on your domain, you could recover lost tracking signals that would otherwise be blocked or restricted. In fact, Google and Cloudflare reported that early testers saw an 11% increase in the data captured by their tags. There's more conversions and analytics events being recorded without any extra ad spend. To sum up, Google Tag Gateway gives you more reliable tracking data. It avoids third-party script blockers and browser privacy limits by making your Google tags first-party elements. In other words, things like Safari ITP or uBlock are less likely to block your analytics. It gives you better site performance, as Cloudflare acts as a middleman, a CDN, so your tags load from a server closer to the user, and this reduces latency and can even lighten the load of your web server. One setup for all your Google tags. So with one configuration, you cover Google Analytics 4 and Google Ads tracking at the same time. And if you're using Google Tag Manager, which I will show you in this video, it works seamlessly with that as well. It's actually a few clicks job, and it's completely free on any Cloudflare plan. Let's get started. First, we need to ensure that Google Tag Manager is connected to the website and is installed in the website code. For that, we will hit the preview mode of Google Tag Manager, connect with Google Tag Assistant to the website, and now you can see that GTM is loading, and also GA4 is sending a hit, so it's installed on the website, but GTM is connected and it's loading, so everything is okay. We can close the windows and now go to Google Tag Assistant admin and go to Google Tag Gateway. Then we will walk through the instructions here. We will hit continue. Then after signing up with the Google account, I will hit again sign up into Cloudflare. And now, as you can see, it is activated. I will hit complete setup. And all done, the setup is complete. So for the client side setup of Google Tag Gateway, you don't need to change the Google Tag Manager code snippet that is on your website. But for server side, you need to change with your own domain folder. But for this integration, this is all. So you can do this Google Tag Gateway connection with a free a Cloudflare account, and now the Google tags will be proxied by Cloudflare. So this was the whole setup. It is pretty simple, but the only downside is that it's only working for the Google tags. If you want the same first party benefits for multiple platforms, I think you should consider a solution like server-side Google Tag Manager with a custom loader. My favorite is Stape custom loader solution. This setup is like building your own tag gateway for everything. It takes a little bit more effort to set up, but it's way more flexible. With server-side tagging, you can send data to Google, Facebook, TikTok, and many other platforms, all from your own domain. Essentially, your site collects data and then distributes it to each platform's API behind the scenes using a custom loader script such as Tapes. This means better tracking for all your marketing efforts, not just Google. Now, server-side tagging with a tool like Stape does require a bit more technical work and a subscription for a server hosting, but many marketers find the boost in the data worth it. In fact, if you're already gone the server-side route, you probably don't need Google Tag Gateway in the first place. But for those of you not ready for a full server-side implementation, Google Tag Gateway via Cloudflare is a fantastic quick win. It's basically flipping a switch to get better Google Analytics and ads data. All right, that's a wrap for today's tutorial. I hope you found this helpful and that you're excited to try out the new Google Tag Gateway for advertising on your own website. And if you want more straightforward tutorials on marketing tech, subscribe to my channel. I'd love to have you in my community. Drop any questions or thoughts in the comments below. I do read them. And let me know if you're using Google Tag Gateway and if you're considering the server-side GTM approach. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.